Welcome, welcome to the 100th Kitch at Home radio show spectacular, or T1KAHRS for short. Everyone's gathered together at Hotel Hollywood to help Kitch celebrate her 100th show. And now the moment you've all been waiting for, here's Kitch! Can you lift your feet, please? Still too much? I changed the title. Well, it's a little late for that, but I want everything to be perfect for tonight's celebration.
It will be. Quit worrying already.
Look, you've invited all these swell celebrities here from your past shows. I mean, to this big fancy hotel. It's gonna be a great weekend.
Yeah, you're right. And hey, listen, thanks for agreeing to be the desk clerk.
I know you are, but what am I?
No, really, you need to get this whole place vacuumed by, like, noon.
Well, that's all the setup for this show taken care of. I'm just gonna go check on the place cards for dinner.
We couldn't seat Frank Serpico, you know, next to Michael Corleone. For so many reasons.
Hi. Hi there. James T. Kirk, landing party of three. Party of three. Listen, can I have the room key, please? I'm in a bit of a rush.
Okay, room 203.
Where do I sign?
Jeez, what's the matter? Is someone chasing you?
No. Heavens no. Could we speed this up?
I have to get the ledger.
Ah, right. Is that it right there?
No, that's a copy menu.
Oh, I see. You can sign any paper you wanted. I mean, it wouldn't mean anything. I have to get your name in the books.
Right. Could I sign later, maybe?
For the last time, I did not back over your foot with the car.
Oh my god. I wasn't fast enough.
Doctor, I know when my foot has been run over.
What if I did? It's not like you could feel it or anything. You're practically made out of metal.
What I am, or am not made out of, is entirely beside the point. You backed over my foot when I was unloading the trunk.
It was an accident, Spock. An accident.
That remains to be seen.
You know, I don't like not knowing if I've been threatened or not. Crazy Vulcan.
Wow. Did you buy them like that?
When running a spaceship, I couldn't trust them more. Land does something to them. I don't know.
Hey, Jim. We all set?
Nearly. I just have to put my old John Hancock in this ledger here, and then we can go upstairs.
What room did we get?
I'm sure whatever room he acquired will be more than satisfactory. I have very low requirements.
Huh. That must pair nicely with your low expectations.
Just sign right there.
It was an accident.
The date. All right. We're all good to go. Who has the bags?
Not me.
I seem to have failed to...
Now who's forgetful?
Leaving me at the rest station was not an act of forgetfulness.
That was an accident. I just changed my mind. Jim, get in the car. We have to drive back to Phoenix. There's someone I need to leave behind back there.
All right, you two, enough. I will get the bags. Jim, it was my responsibility.
No, that's all right.
If you go out there again with phones, I may never see you two again. Yes, you two get the bags. We'll rendezvous in the lounge in, say, 45 minutes.
45 minutes, Captain.
Right. 5 minutes for you to get the bags and 40 minutes to argue.
This is a no cell phone event. So, hand them over.
But these are communicators.
Yeah, how will Spock listen to No Moon Over Vulcan in the morning? Or wake up with Sawaktalara Yuris and Levkawardra Hadak?
I'm so sorry.
Rules are rules. Drive time with Peg and Peter Puppet on the Howdy Doody radio will just have to do. Just drop them in the box.
Ah, yes, a box. Very secure.
You know, I'm starting to see what your doctor friend sees in you.
I beg your pardon.
Huh. First raised eyebrow of the day.
That's what you think.
You'll get him back at the end of the event,
but that could be days from now.
Nothing gets by you, huh? All messages go through the front desk. If someone contacts you, I will let you know.
With a large gathering such as this, you will need some extra security. Might I offer my assistance?
Spock, what are you doing?
You're not a security officer. We're here to rest. Have fun.
Fun, Captain.
Yeah, fun, Spock.
The thing you managed to suck out of every situation.
Excuse me. Perhaps I should have laughed when you backed over my toe.
That was an accident!
Hotel Hollywood, Pee-wee speaking.
What? 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 What?
Oh, listen, I'm gonna have to hand you over to a friend of mine who also does phone routines.
Mr. Newhart, I think it's for you.
Hello?
What?
I did that bit already.
Hey guys, shh! He's trying to use the phone!
Well, what can we help you with?
You staying a few nights for the event.
Great, well, what's the name?
You are the event.
Well, there's no show. It's just a dinner. There will be when you get here.
I see. What's a name?
Well, I understand wanting to be discreet, but we really need a name.
Okay. You want the whole title there? All of it? Okay. Is Mistress of the Dark your middle name or?
Oh, okay.
It's a nickname. I go by Sunny.
No, I never thought of that comparison before.
Elvira. All right. We can do that. Well, we have several rooms. They're empty.
No, we usually rent them out empty, and if you happen to meet someone, we can provide you with a queen bed.
I don't know.
Well, a king would be the size up. Queen should be fine. All right, there's just a few more details here. We're going to need a license plate to your car. you're driving it now, so you don't know. No, don't check in the glove compartment while you're driving this, Elvira. Let's look when you stop. We could get the make and model written down. It's a macabre mobile. I don't think that mobiles are really registered, though Bruce Wayne came in one. We can make an exception. If we did for him, we can for you. I'm sure yours is better than his, too. Okay, we can discuss payment when you get here. Now don't lose your temper, Miss Elvira. That's not what I meant. I'm really not interested in an old handbag, though my briefcase is getting a little shabby. Or a ruby ring. I could look. There may be a pawn shop somewhere between where you are and here. Where are you exactly? In the desert. I see. Is there a sign or anything? Oh, you see a sign ahead. 50 miles to Aunt Sally's pecan pralines. No, that doesn't help. No, I wouldn't want you to bring me a log. I'm allergic to nuts. That was in bad taste. There's one other policy you should be aware of when you get here. You're talking on the phone with me when you're driving, so this is a no cell phone event. And a what? Dagger? You're probably gonna have to check that too. I'm sorry, you're breaking up, Elvira. The tumbleweed's interfering with the cell service. You had a question about the menu? Oh, I thought you said something about melons. Ah, well, look, maybe we can find something for you to do in the show that we aren't having. Our drapes? Yeah, they have tassels. Elvira, how much is that ruby ring really worth? Hello? Darn tumbleweed.
Hey, Eddie, where's Betty?
She's getting ready.
Did you forget the sparkle confetti?
Don't be petty.
Well, have you got it already?
No.
But I forgot the spaghetti.
Great. All we have is toast and jelly.
Should I call the deli?
No, I called Ellie.
Your hands are all sweaty.
Well, did she mention Freddy?
No. Why, are you and Ellie going steady?
No, I'm just not ready.
If you ask me, you should take Kenny.
What?
Nothing. I said you're really friendly.
You need help with that box? It looks awful heavy.
No, I don't need your help, Betty. I've had plenty.
I said I was sorry I forgot the spaghetti.
No, you just offered to call the deli.
Well, should I?
I could get pie.
No, don't start a new rhyme. It'll make me cry.
You never know until you try.
Eddie, please.
I said goodbye. Okay, Eddie, come back here. You're a wonderful sound effects man, so I just want to give you this opportunity to express one of your talents. People come up to me, they say, Kitch, you do a radio show. There's certain things you just can't capture unless you have visuals. So, Eddie from The Gong Show, I would like to put you to the test. Can you give us the sound effect of someone looking uncomfortable? Here's that sound effect right now. Challenge accepted and accomplished.
I bet I could do better.
Mr. Spindler, I'm sure you could, but we haven't got the time.
Well, maybe not, but I'm sure you'll have time for this. In my breast pocket, I just happen to have the compilation of the top 10 sound effects used on the Kitchen Home Show.
You put it together? Oh, I can't wait.
Your sweet whiskers.
I'm a dog.
Dogs have
whiskers.
Let's
play it right now.
Oh, mercy. That's the wrong tape. Here, this is the right one.
Oh boy, here come our most popular guest stars, Jonathan Brewster and Dr. Einstein. Oh, I hope their room's okay. You know, those two make an art form out of arguing.
All right, we're back! And you fellas are on the air. How's that chair coming for you?
Will you tell him to stop breathing down my neck?
I'm not breathing down your neck. I'm trying to read you the instructions. Remove all parts from the kit box and remove all plastic covers from the parts. Separate and organize in different pieces of the chair so you can find them all, and that's step one. I don't see what I'm doing so wrong.
Let me see. It has everyone on it that we need to dispose of.
Everyone? This is the wrong list.
Really? I must have grabbed it this morning without my glasses, when I was very tired and I hadn't eaten yet.
Would you like to add a few more excuses to that?
Did you have the cord laying over the stove again? Einstein?
No, I had to. There was no plug, and I can't help it. It's not my fault.
Wow, see any good films on your way down that road of denial?
Hey, Johnny.
I'll get you gloves.
Oh, can you also...
I'll get you a scarf.
There's also...
I'll get you a hat. Now just shovel the snow. I'm gone. No, we're not repeating the peanut incident.
You're so clever, Johnny.
Nothing is going to make up for the bubblegum incident while we were driving. Nothing.
Must you scream and shout at me all the time?
Yes, I must. It's part of my charm.
See, Johnny, it's really very simple.
If it's so simple, why are you standing on my hand? Well, come on, Max. Read me the instructions. Let me get this over with before the Who's come back.
Who?
Let's not start an Abbott and Costello routine. Will you just pick up the ornaments and bring them here? How do you feel if I planted all the bulbs on top of the ground, huh?
Those different daffodils
have really? Do I look like Martha Stewart to you? I don't know that. And here's the real shocker. I don't care. Read the instructions.
Right, first we inspect. Tent, fly, and poles for defects, wear, and damage.
Do we have a tent?
Yes.
Do we have the poles?
Yes.
Do we have the pegs?
Yes.
Inspection over. Step two. Great, we have a step ladder, but now I don't need it because the star fell over.
Well, Johnny, it's broken.
That's fine, it matches the ornaments now.
We have to fix it.
Oh, okay. There, it's fixed.
It's very simple, Johnny. Here, let me see. See, that's a three stitch, so it's A, and you just go down to four, which is A, and then down to here, it says A 10 3.25, so you just set the second knob to five, that's all.
Boy, am I stupid. Yeah, okay, this is what I heard. Tent, blah, blah, corners, blah, blah, tension, blah, blah, pitch. Whatever, whatever, wheel, whatever, whatever, wheel, whatever, whatever, tighten, bolt, whatever, whatever, wheel. Alignment, 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 handlebar, got it.
Wait. I'm sorry, Johnny.
I'm sorry, Johnny.
Fine.
I said I was sorry, Johnny.
I said I was sorry, and yet you're still saying it.
Johnny?
Oh, why couldn't you change my name every time you change my face? You're in my light. You're still in my light.
Well, what if it doesn't...
What? Have a room? It's an inn.
No, no, you know what? I have people all around.
What if it doesn't have people all around? Where do you get your sentences?
From my mind.
Well, that explains that.
Green bean casserole.
Well, thanks for coming over to let me know. We'll see you in the new year.
Johnny, is it true that that Bing Crosby's going to come by later and sing us a song?
What fever dream was this?
On the radio.
We're only staying here because we're the Broil Gardeners.
Yes, I regret what we did to that hedge.
I am halfway between really needing you to explain that and never wanting you to explain that.
I just want to say this while it's fresh. I don't mind Christmas music after Halloween.
I don't know that the appliances are sticky, but they sure need wiped down.
Maybe we should empty the crumbs from the toaster tree.
Why do you say that so creepily?
You want to fold it backwards like a trash bag.
Every word you say sounds creepy. I give up.
No, Johnny, I'm lost in here.
How do you get lost in a bathroom?
Not lost like lost. I mean, I know how to get out of here when the light was on.
Oh, jeez. All right, thank goodness. The door opened. Where are you?
I'm in the bathroom.
I know that. Where in the bathroom?
I'm over here.
Oh, okay. It's dark. Light a match.
All right. Let me see. There we are. Oh, hot.
I don't know if this escaped you, but we're in the dark again.
All right. That was my last match.
Why did you use our only match for 5 seconds?
I was using it to see if there were any more matches.
Guess not. You copied down the formula before we all get caught or sent to another planet. I wouldn't mind going to, as long as you didn't come with me.
Johnny, I heard that.
Oh, good. Nothing's wrong with your ears. Copy it down now before we get caught. No one else is buried here, I hope.
No, I don't think so, Johnny. It looks pretty clear here.
Good. I wouldn't want anyone else to get here first.
Or last, as the case may be.
Stop freaking me out in the woods. Wait a minute. Is that a musical? Don't lie to me.
It's a musical. But what's wrong with musicals? I don't understand. I just want to see something happy, something light of heart to help me.
You need help, all right.
Yep. Shh, Johnny.
This isn't the library. They're playing Henry V next door. You can hear the cavalry.
Johnny, shh, I think it's about to start.
Oh, joy. What is this? Man, didn't I miss the war commercial?
It's not a commercial, Johnny, please. It's happening now. It's very serious.
Is it serious? Why are they playing a cartoon before it and a musical afterwards?
Shh.
There goes Henry. There's one thing you should know as we go on here. I don't really care what they have to say about it. I just want to know the instructions, what to do. Not what they think it should do, not what they think is going to happen. I don't want to hear about Elgo Room. You're in my light again.
That's not right, Johnny. You have to cook with love.
Well, a dash of hatred is just going to have to do. Can I do any real cooking?
We're not cooking, Johnny. We're baking.
Why don't you correct me when I'm doing something I really don't even want to think about?
There's a container of sprinkles in here. I should make something fun.
No, don't make something fun. Just get the soup.
Gee, I don't feel so well.
Well, really should have thought of that before you had that pepper-noose.
And don't forget the eggnog. The eggnog was quite nice, actually. The cinnamon on there.
Cinnamon or no cinnamon, I don't like eggs.
Said it. You don't even know what's in it, and you'll hate it.
Wow, what a valuable lesson I just learned here. What is in it? Why is this counter, like, perpetually wet?
Well, it is right next to the sink.
I don't want logical explanations. I want you to be as angry as I am. The county sheriff, or whatever the heck they have in this podunk town.
I don't know what that means, but it sounded insulting. It's a very nice little town, where everybody knows everybody.
Yeah! That'll come in handy. Two criminals running from the law. We got really lucky that Superman got kryptonite poisoning. And it's so funny, because Clark Kent just happens to have come down with the flu at the same time. You people really need to wake up around here. Is this poison ivy? Quick, I need answers.
I have questions.
All right, 6-1.
I'm seeing a problem with communication. All right, so, Dr. Einstein, why don't you give your retort to what Jonathan has just said to you? Some pretty hostile things. You want me to tell him hostile things? Look at that face. I can't tell him hostile things.
No, he said them to you.
Oh, right, excuse me, sorry. Forgive me, Johnny. The doctor says I have to do this. I don't really appreciate how you always... And then sometimes when you... Oh, I just want to... And then other times when I've messed up and I didn't mean to, then... And you get all... And that face, you get that face, Johnny, and oh, I can't breathe, and then... Oh, and then afterwards, I'm all right again, and then something else happens. And, like when we... And then that man, he just died, and I didn't know what to do with him. It wasn't all my fault, you know. I mean, we are partners, and I can't handle all the blood all the time, and I just wish I was... But if I was, I know that... So we might as well just forget about it, and Johnny, please don't strangle me.
Okay, that was pretty thorough. We are at the end.
Or is it just the beginning?
Good point. For the last and final time, I will get it. Herkimer here doesn't have his card, his guest pass thing for the show tonight. It's dinner and a show, right?
Is it dinner and a show or just dinner?
I'm so glad that you listened to me the first time so I don't have to say it 100 more times, because you know what, that gets agitating. Answers. I have questions. Is this whole weekend gonna be like this, rehashing old bits? No, I'm sorry, it's just, well, if you heard Bob Newhart talking to Elvira over the phone, then you're mistaken, because, well, he told her that there wasn't a show, and there is a show. It's more of a presentation.
No, I only got tickets for the show, not the presentation, Johnny.
101? Well, why would he tell her that there isn't a show when there is one?
A presentation,
Well, when
Johnny.
Bob Newhart starts improvising, you just kinda have to let him go and say whatever he wants. Kinda like you guys. Actually, we have a separate table for people who are improv. Like, we have a separate table for the mobsters. Oh, really? Where does Al Pacino sit? Far away from himself. Great, I'm part of the improv group. Couldn't have been placebo. All right, get the tickets.
There's only one here. Oh, no, wait, there's two. Isn't that funny how that happens sometimes?
Excuse me if I don't have a laughing fit right here in the lobby.
Let's go.
I still have to do all your ironing.
I told you I would do it.
No, you just keep hitting your head on the ironing board and ironing your thumbs.
Actually, last time it was more of the knuckles.
Yeah, well, that's because you picked up the iron from the wrong direction.
I hope it heals by tonight.
Skin doesn't work that way.
But I should know, I'm the surgeon.
I think my face is an example of exactly how much you do and do not know.
Sorry, Johnny.
My God, it's official. If we literally strapped you to a chair and forced you to listen to a reel of yourself saying that, which of what we just did, you still wouldn't learn.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean it.
Gotham Police. Jim Gordon. You're under arrest. For what? Stealing jokes.
I didn't steal any jokes. You got the wrong gal, see?
Oh, you didn't? Think back.
I'm through taking suggestions from you, Captain Question Mark.
I am through taking orders from you, Captain Queen.
Well, then do us all a favor and leave. I'd really like to know how a little authority can turn a friendly neighborhood forensic scientist into Freddy Krueger.
Wait, how a little authority can turn a neighborhood dentist into the seawolf.
Well, you were busy playing Mayor Oswald. I was the one that had to follow you around to do all that paperwork. There wouldn't have been all that paperwork if you hadn't have shot somebody. Maybe I wouldn't have had to shoot someone if they had focused on doing their job of running Gotham and forgetting about their silly flirtations. You didn't shoot someone, Ed. You shot me.
You were supposed to be visiting kids at a school, not asking people out on romantic dinners.
Oh, dinner schmimmer, Ed. I visited with those kids just like I was supposed to.
Well, you were trying to tie a Spanish running noose. I dived overboard to rescue those two girls, which wouldn't have been necessary if you hadn't rammed their canoe. Which I wouldn't have rammed if you'd been at your watch on the bow.
Oh, bow schmow, Jerry. I was at the pointy end of the boat where I was supposed to be.
Yeah, and we got a call from a parent whose child you told to kick other children down the stairs if they were mean to them. Only if the friendship thing didn't work out. And anyway, we wouldn't even have been there long enough for me to meet that kid if we had just gone home when I asked you to. Yeah. We wouldn't have been there during lunchtime if you hadn't spent 3 hours cutting the ribbon for the new bank. I think I distinctly remember someone saying, "Mingle, Oswald!" If you had mingled when we got there and cut the ribbon, we could have been out of there in 10 minutes, but no. Most people stop mingling when they're reshaking the same hands.
Well, for your information, canoes are not required to have running lights. Back to
the box. You wouldn't have been out there, lost in the dark, if you had gone home when I asked you to.
It wouldn't have been that dark in the harbor if you hadn't dragged our anchor over that power cable. I think I distinctly remember somebody saying, "Drop the anchor." If you had dropped the anchor when I gave you the command to drop the anchor, then you wouldn't have cut the cable.
I gave you clear and simple instructions. Well, if you'd give me instructions in English instead of all that riddle nonsense, the shorter I am, the bigger I am. What am I?
If you'd give a command in English once instead of all that nautical baloney, drop the anchor aboard and starboard abaft the port.
Temper. That's great, Ed, because I'm just about to lose mine. Well, thank you for what? This cold. I wouldn't have it if you hadn't taken me to the dock and pushed me in the water. I pushed you in the water, huh? Seems like to me you fell in. I was waiting for one of your world famous riddles, telling me that it was all a joke and that you didn't mean it.
Oh, boy, thank you.
For what?
For this cold. I wouldn't have it if you didn't pull me off the dock and drag me through the water.
I dragged you through the water and pulled you off the dock, huh?
I was waiting for one of your world famous commands to let go of the rope. You never told me to let go of the rope.
Listen, fella, the average dummy has enough sense to know that when someone tries to shoot you down by the docks, the chances are they probably don't want you hanging around anymore. How am I supposed to pick up and settle things like that?
Now look, fella, the average dummy has enough sense to let go of the line.
How am I supposed to know technical stuff like that?
Subtle? Now let's calm down here. I can't stand all this fighting. I mean, it reminds me of me and my ex-wife. Oh, Oswald would just love that, wouldn't you? I'd have more fun married to Count Dracula. Well, at least you two would have something in common. You're both sponges. Well, let's just see who's sponging off of who when we get to Arkham. A few weeks in there and you'll be begging for my company. Yes, that is if I'm not too distracted by the fact that everyone else in Gotham has died. Get off your high horse. I know your finest wish is to blow up Gotham. There is a bomb on top of a computer. Around the computer there is a phone, a hairbrush, keys, and a cup. When the explosion comes, which item is destroyed first? Answer? The bomb. Oh, that does it. One more riddle and I'm calling the police myself. What has four legs? That's it!
Well, if we do fold in, we'll have 90 seconds until hypothermia sets in.
One more fact, you're going in that hole.
The wall-eyed
fight. Okay, that's it!
Allow me to defend myself like Shelley Duvall did in the Fairy Tale Theater Party Special. I don't like to think of it as stealing. I like to think of it as being inspired. It's a takeoff, a parody, a spoof. Take the Kitch at Home show 93. That was more commentary than anything else, of imagining what all the Star Trek characters must really be thinking. Okay, Harpo, that will be all. But don't go far. I hear Norman Bates will be attending the dinner tonight. Yeah. Thanks.
Explain this procedure.
Tell me more so that I can dispute you while tugging on my shirt.
Ever since I first saw Data at the entrance evaluation at the Starfleet Academy, I've wanted to understand it. I became a student of the works of Dr. Noni and Soong, Data's creator, and I have tried to continue his work. I believe I am very close to the breakthrough that will enable me to duplicate Dr. Soong's work and replicate this.
I would like to start by saying I'm a big fan of a doctor, but then tell you I can do better than they did. In short, I have an odd and creepy desire to duplicate Mr. Data, and if anyone tries to stop me, I will continue to repeat how I'd like to take him apart in serial killer detail. Side note, I will now and forever refer to Data as this.
But as a first step, I must disassemble and study it. Data is going to be my guide.
Also, I formally demand that this not only be on board with my proposal of insanity, but help me every step of the way as I disassemble his rights. And while I am talking, I will not look at it, but I will gesture in its general direction to further prove the confusing mixture of awe and disrespect that I have towards this.
Data?
It sounds intriguing.
Data, please say something so I don't have to. I shall respond simply with a touch of optimism in my voice. That would suggest my sentiment of please don't kill me. It sounds intriguing. Was I smiling?
How will you proceed? I will run a full diagnostic on Data, evaluating the condition of its current software. I will then dump its core memory into the Starbase mainframe computer and begin a detailed analysis of its construction.
You've constructed a positronic brain?
How will you proceed? That is to say, what other creepy things do you have planned? I'll scan it nonchalantly, but I'm going to tell you a bunch of jargon so I sound professional. In all your years, have you ever achieved anything that would make me less scared about this procedure? You have constructed a positronic brain, because you know that is what I have, right? Yes.
Have you determined how the electron resistance across the neural filaments is to be resolved?
Not precisely.
That would seem to be a necessary first step.
Do you know how it works? No, that's why I'm going to take you apart. not precisely. Knowing what the heck you are doing would seem to be a necessary first step.
I am confident that I will find the answer once I examine the filament links in your anterior cortex.
But if the answer is not forthcoming, your model will not function.
I do not anticipate any problems.
Let me interrupt your expertise with my confidence, real quick. I do not anticipate any problems. And yes, I am speaking directly to you, Captain Picard, so I can make you feel as important as I think I am, while minimizing the involvement of this who is showing me up.
You seem a little vague on the specifics.
What are the risks to Commander Data? Negligible.
Captain, I believe his basic research lacks the specifics necessary to support an experiment of this magnitude.
You seem a little vague on the specifics. This is not unlike watching a close-up magic show. Will Mr. Data survive you?
Negligible? The risks are so small and unimportant they aren't worth considering. This would like to weigh in. Captain, he cannot do it. Allow me to sigh so heavily no one can miss my irritation that it spoke again.
Commander Data is a valued member of my bridge crew, based on what I've heard. I cannot allow Commander Data to submit himself to this experiment.
Sorry, not sorry. I will not allow him to undergo this procedure. You see, I can also talk for him.
I was afraid this might be your attitude, Captain. Here are Starfleet's transfer orders, separating Commander Data from the Enterprise and reassigning it to Starbase 173 under my command. Data, I will see you in my office tomorrow at 0900 hours.
I'm going to say I was afraid this might be your attitude, but I will be holding back a smile. Starfleet's is nay. It will be reassigned to Starbase 173, stationed dangerously close to the neutral zone, under my command. Data, I'll see you in my office whenever the heck I say. Stay frosty. Comlink drop.
Well, all right, I guess I can let you off with a warning. Thanks, Jim. Shall I start blending in with your guests? Okay, you might want to hide your badge, though. Just try and put folks at ease. I want them to feel safe, but not like there's anything that they need to be saved from. That's the duty of a security guard. Better call Harvey and ask him to check on my apartment while I'm gone. We could run pretty late.
Hey! Yeah, you? Just what do you think you're doing?
Excuse me?
In case you didn't read the sign, this is a no-cell phone event. No distractions. We must be present. Live in the moment!
Are you sure? Because I could live without this
Huey, it's alright. He's our security guard. Well, okay, but I'll be watching you.
Always watching. Watching.
Well, story of my life. Make an enemy just dialing my phone. I have a room. Do you have a bag? No, do you have a bag? Well, this isn't going to work if you're just guessing.
I have a room.
Ah, done. Can I have it?
Yeah.
And the key?
Oh, cripes, I don't want to pay extra for a key. Just put it on my tab.
Would that be your bar tab?
Where? This is a no-alcohol event.
No need.
I brought my own.
Is Manny with you by any chance?
No, he's minding the bookstore, making sure no customers come in.
I'd sure feel better if someone was minding you.
It's all right. Everybody minds me.
Ugh, feel a bit dizzy. Can I have a lie down on the couch
here? There's no couch. Bernard, that's the floor. There's no couch.
Then why? Is it so comfy?
Are you seeing double yet?
No, there's only one of this invisible couch.
But hang on, I think I see an invisible chair that looks much more comfortable.
Bernard, I'm gonna have Pee-wee take you to your room.
I thought you said his name was Pee-wee.
I did.
And they say I have problems.
Who's they?
I don't know, but they asked me not to talk about it.
Talk about what?
Good job. Zachary.
Brownie, stop pulling on my purse, please. I have the tickets.
I'll check us in.
Hi, Kitch. How's it going? You look so cute behind the front desk. Brownie, stop pulling on my arm.
Do you have the tickets, dear? She needs them.
No, I thought that
we're
was
already signed up. We're sharing the same room.
Husky, remember? I thought you said she needed the tickets.
I did. It just hits me. Manny and I sound like an old married couple. I'm flustered. It's a good thing I'm lying down on thin air.
You keep the tickets until the dinner and you've already signed in.
Well, where's the key then? I'm gonna give it to Mom now, Clifford. Room 100.
Perfect. Come on, kids.
Hi, Alex. Hi, Spotty. Hi, Lindsay. Hi, Socks. Hi, Fred. Hi, George. Hi, Wrinkle. Hi, Puddles. Hi, Jonathan. Hi, Sonnet. Hi, Star. Hi, Whisper. Hi, Snoopy.
You forgot us. Hi, Clifford. Hi, Brownie.
Okay, come on, kids. Let's get in our room. Brownie, stop pulling my
hand. All right, that'll do it. I think I'm going to leg it to my room and have a lie down before this up. Real furniture is the best.
Can I have your mobile extension, please?
I barely know you.
Your cell phone.
Oh, right. Here. Manny has the other tin can.
Hey, my orange juice phone isn't half this nice.
Well, keep it. I'll throw in the string for free.
Gee, thanks.
Kitch, just between you and me. I don't think he's the full shilling.
Am I the only one that feels like we're driving through the La Brea Tar Pits?
Careful, Frank. We have precious cargo on board.
Well, who'd say precious exactly?
All right, then adorable.
I just know there's a road under here somewhere.
Hey, Marty, wear that army helmet I gave you.
All right.
It's filled with shaving cream. I hope.
That's Frank's. Try the other one.
Did you put shaving cream in my helmet again?
Of course, Frank. It matches the aftershave in your slippers.
Did you go through my suitcase?
The road!
Where?
Well, I think that sums up Frank's driving nicely.
I see a blinding white light. I can't see anything. Well, that's it. We didn't make it.
Could you smile?
No, just act natural. Just act like you're not here.
I don't have to act.
I can't feel my feet. They're completely numb from reflexively pressing on the floor when Frank took that last curve.
I take it you're the royal photographer.
I'm not Roy. Kitch just hired me to take pictures, candid pictures of the guests, just being themselves.
That must be pretty pricey.
I'm doing it for free. I would only make money if someone wanted to buy back their photo. Actually, a lot of people have already.
Will you get that flash bulb out of my face? It's against regulations for civilians to take pictures of Army majors without their explicit consent.
Here, Andy, get one of me shoving Frank in his own suitcase.
And you know, people treat weirdos like they're weird. Like they don't even matter. And that's how I feel about it.
Mr. Hirschfield.
Hershey.
Like the kiss.
Hershey? Wouldn't it be faster for you to just tell me the things that don't make you sad?
Actually, no.
Excuse me, the Wes Anderson movie is being filmed across the street.
I can handle it.
Hirschfield.
Hershey.
You've never been in a Kitch at Home show before. What are you doing here?
I'm a lawyer.
See, you're the law, and I'm the year.
Get out of my way.
Pardon me.
Hershey, stop barking.
I never thought I'd have to say this, but no dog fights in the lobby.
Well, I'm not sure what that was, but I think I won.
Pardon me.
Hang on, I want to finish the sentence.
There are some things you can't share without ending up liking each other. And knocking out a 12-foot mountain troll is one of them.
Wow. Trolls?
Not the cute kind.
You've never read Harry Potter before?
No, I was too busy reading movie scripts.
They made a movie out of this.
Several.
Great. Another thing I missed out on doing Boop Scout films.
I have a complaint. For two of us.
For who?
Greta Ann Garbo?
My driving companion.
She said that you did not have a place for her in the show.
Well, there's no show. I mean, it's just a presentation. It's just clips. I'm really sorry.
Calm down, Pinocchio. If there's no show, there's no show. She'll understand. In 3 to 5 years. But we would like our room.
You're sharing a room?
Do you want to get slept again?
No, I'll get your key here.
I got the bag.
Oh, hi, Elvira. I hear you two are
nothing. Doing nothing at all.
Billy, hi.
Oh, sorry about that. She's just nothing without her coffee.
Okay.
And you're nothing without your glass of blood. We're a perfect match. I'll get the bags.
Oh, I already got them. I don't know what she's gonna carry. Except a grudge.
Listen, Elvira, I'm really sorry that we couldn't work you into the presentation. I mean, I had no idea. It's just I have a really large agenda here and everything.
I bet you do.
Eyes in the back of your head.
How do you do that?
I don't know. Let me have a little talk with her, okay?
Pee-wee.
Pee-wee,
what are you doing?
Why are you looking at the ceiling?
I was just trying to roll my eyes back. Never mind. What can I do for you, Jim?
Kitch, she's ready to send people in to dinner. She just wanted you to get everyone together.
Will do, El Capitan.
Never thought I'd miss Gotham.
Are you looking for me?
I don't think so.
Oh, bother.
I mean, it's time for dinner.
Oh, I could do that. I don't think many people have trusted me with much, except sound effects. So if you were to fall off the stairs or out the window, I could do something for that. But I guess I could call people for dinner.
I thought we had a sound effects person. Two of them.
Well, now they have three.
Boy, everyone's getting kind of hangry before dinner.
Mr. O'Connor.
What?
Why do you always sound flustered?
Is this an interview? I'm trying to put on my pants.
Hangry, hangry, hangry.
Make a any ode to you too. I'm busy here. I'm trying to iron my shirt.
I appreciate that, but...
Hi.
Hello. I appreciate that, but I just have to tell you that dinner is being served now.
Right now? Alright, well, I'll be down in a few minutes. Hey, listen, I can't find this room.
Oh, that's Elvira and Greta Garbo. They're in, room 304. Sorry, my handwriting sucks.
Elvira, she's your friend. Are you sure you wouldn't wanna...
No. You go right ahead. Enjoy yourself.
Well, they wouldn't dare hurt a man wearing glasses.
Where's that phone?
Hello? Well, I'm late for dinner, and I'm trying to get into my pants, and I'm trying...
What do you mean, how difficult is that?
Yes, and the frost is on the pumpkin. I'm really busy.
Well, they just called dinner, and with all these people, I'm sure it'll be gone in 5 minutes.
I said, listen, why aren't you here?
You were invited, weren't you?
Oh, you have a cold.
Oh, that's a shame. You would have made a great narrator.
I don't think anyone's narrating.
I'm sorry, Bing.
Well, the important thing is that you just take care of yourself. And it was very nice of you to call in and be the person who was sick at home in bed, make audience members who are sick feel better.
Well, I don't want to timestamp this, but it's winter. People get colds in the winter.
Well, if people listen to this again in spring, they probably could have spring fever.
Summer, hay fever.
fall? Change of season. All right, well, I think we've covered all bases. I'm late for dinner. Yes, I got the tie clip. What's funny about the way I say clip? What do you mean the eye disappears? All right. When I talk, the eye disappears. And I have to disappear right now. All right, goodbye. I've never had this much trouble getting on pants in the past. I want a nice, juicy steak. Smothered in gravy. And radishes that my wife said I should be eating instead. I'll put radishes in the gravy.
Watch it! Why is it everywhere I go, I run into you, Kismet? You almost destroyed this native Fallopian delicacy.
Are those eyeballs on there?
It grows on you.
Yeah, it does look like it's growing. Who would have such a thing?
Don't keep me waiting all day. I wish to digest in the chance event there's dancing.
Right away! You'll need at least a month with that slop.
Who ordered the chicken con carne?
Anyone but me.
Oh, that was mine.
Shut up, Mel. Take it! Smell is ruining my shrimp Alfredo. That's a very difficult thing to do.
Who had the meatloaf?
No one. Sally ordered the house salad, and I ordered the steak and the string beans.
Oh, wait, that was mine. I ordered that.
I knew someone ordered the meatloaf. You lied to me, you know. Don't do that.
And the way it died.
Guess there's nothing to talk about while you're eating. That's all right, Norman. We've all killed a houseplant or two.
Of all the injustice!
Excuse me, won't you? Oswald, what's the matter now? Keep your voice down.
You know what I think the problem is, Jim? I need to show them that I deserve my own table.
You don't.
They probably see a person like me and think he can hold his own sitting with rival mob bosses.
They don't.
You know it's a silly little thing, but I don't ask for much.
You do.
Having my own private table is like the one thing that makes me happy.
You aren't.
I do not understand what I am doing wrong. I felt like I really vibed with the management here.
You didn't.
I mean, if I hadn't shown up today, they probably would have wondered where I was.
They wouldn't.
Because I am a nice guy, right?
You're not.
I tip in cash.
So?
And I can't think of one reason they wouldn't have given me my own table.
I can.
Thanks for listening, Jim.
I had no choice.
And that one was for you, Seth MacFarlane.
I'd like to welcome each and every one of you to Kitch 100, because I was advised to shorten the title. You know, there's a very good reason I'm in radio, is when I tried to star in a feature film, it looked a little something like this. Cue the sound therapy track. That was sand.
My eye, I can't see.
Can you open it?
If I could open it, I could see.
Maybe you should keep walking.
I can't do the fancy dressage dance across the sand right now. I can't
see.
Yeah,
but the worms are sure to hear us.
I think they've heard us.
Just tilt your head back. Let me see.
If I tilt my head back, it'll go further into my eye. You know what?
You guys just go ahead without me. The worms were always coming anyway.
There's nothing I like more than a good formulaic, corny joke, as proven by my intros.
Welcome to Kitch at Home. I hear birds outside my window. Yes, it's summer. I always equate that with my childhood. Also combining two of my favorite things, like vintage car magazines. We have your Chevy Blazer, your pickups, and your El Camino. And then, of course, your basics.
Hey, I have a few award show jokes for you. And the best neckwear award goes to... Wait, it's a tie! What do you call an award-winning potato snack? A championship. Guess what? I won the Most Secretive Guy Award today. I cannot tell you how much this award means to me.
Right?
Dad, do your Marilyn Monroe impression. No, you like it. Dad, please. Go ahead.
Oh, Oswald, it's not that funny, is it?
Well, you're right. That was funny.
But he hasn't done it yet.
Over the years, let's make that many, many years, history has given us countless comedy opportunities. I'd like to share a few of those right now.
There's no reason to be uncivil. I can understand you might be tired after a long day of work. I know those Vestal flames won't fan themselves.
Never!
Yeah, that's what I'm implying. I mean, look at your robes, that pattern, it looks like an adult therapy coloring book. Commodus, is it today, or are we Hercules?
Commodus, of course.
Well, it seems within a few months we're going to be short on supplies. I don't think we're going to make it to Herculean Day.
Tell me, what day is it today?
It's Commodus Day, sir.
And what will tomorrow be?
Commodus Day.
And what about the day after that?
Commodus Day.
And the day after that? And the day after that?
Commodus Day, until the end of time, until, well, I guess Commodus Month, which is, what, August? Is that August, or did you switch that back to Hercules Month? I shall drop it. Anyway, the grain stores.
Yes, what about them?
We don't have any. It seems that you sort of used it all for, like, weaponry and,
I want to say gladiator events, but, I mean, are they really events?
If no one comes,
Who isn't coming? I don't have a list. I gave you a list. You gave me a list. Oh, of the Roman people. Do you have the Greek sector? Someone else was handling that, I assumed. You're trying my patience. I'm not trying. Why don't we move on to something else?
You know what?
You feel like eating again?
I feel like eating again.
Excuse me, it's me in the back with the oddly colored robe.
What is it, number 15?
I can't really hear. Could the Emperor speak up?
I'll try to not whisper and then spontaneously shout, as I'm known for.
And another thing, could Gaius move? Because, you're kind of blocking my view, man. Sorry.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. There. Is that better?
And we're good.
This is why I want to dissolve the Senate.
You said we weren't going to talk about that today. Actually, I think you promised. This is a very private conversation, so we, of course, have 9 people around us at all times. First of all, my father would have come, but this is weak. He doesn't remember me.
Yes, your father's madness. Those who live in glass kings should not throw balls.
I would say touche, but he does believe he is made out of glass.
Shall we talk about the fight tomorrow? I am now going to give you a series of threats against your life directly, in front of all of your army and men, with long pauses. Yes, in between.
Excellent. When is the next ship leaving for there?
Ship? You can walk. I'm not walking all that way.
No, I meant by foot. Horse feet.
Or wheels.
The point is you can get there without going through water.
I wish to take a boat ride.
Well, that's nice, but there's really no way to get there.
Ha! You must think I'm really stupid.
I didn't say that out loud.
If you can't get there by water, how do the trade ships come in?
Sire, are you sure you wouldn't like poisoned now?
What?
No, your daily dose of poison mixed in with your food, so that you gain immunity, so that when the real day comes, you'll be ready.
You think I'm going to get poisoned?
It was a light suggestion at best.
Who's been poisoning me?
Oh, is that something we are supposed to tell? Oh, alright, okay. Nobody.
I would like to fight in the games again.
Okay, impossible request number 364. And look, it lands on a Commodus day. What do you mean, the games? You mean the gladiatorial events for the Roman people? Commodus, I can't call them the Commodines with a straight face. I just can't do it. We tried it last week. It didn't work. Everyone laughed.
Fine, I'll let that go for today.
There we go, exercising that mercy. Who do you wish to fight against?
Not who.
Nobody?
I wish to do a mock fight.
Oh, okay, kind of like the mock emperor thing. Got it.
I am this close to dissolving the entire Senate.
We'll miss you.
Ah,
did you get the leaves stuck in your hair again?
I'm fine, I can handle it.
Yeah, that's the last thing you said about Maximus.
Did he escape again?
If you don't know that he did or didn't escape again, I can't help you. Come on, hold still, let me see. Let's stop moving. Let me see. It doesn't look too bad. Does this hurt?
Ah!
One more leaf, and there, we got it.
Stop laughing, all of you.
Well, I'm sorry, we ran out of laurel leaves to chew on during your last arena spectacular.
You and an ostrich? An ostrich? You know, during my reign, we've enjoyed a much lower rate of military conflict and bloodshed than that of my father's. Let's not do anything to spoil that, shall we?
I was with you right up until you said bloodshed. I came away with a nervous habit of my own. Now I can only stare straight ahead. I noticed that the minute you walked in.
That certainly would have kept temptation at bay when looking back for your vortices.
Why do you keep bringing up the underworld? You're Christian.
I'm familiar with all hells. Ugh. Oh, my shin splint. And now so am I. Well, have the royal marbler make a new one.
He cannot.
Why?
You put him to death, sire.
Ah, yes, he was the one who laughed during dinner.
Right. Then there was the statue of your father, whom the stonemakers claimed was, punched in the face repeatedly, but we thought we'd leave that discussion between you and the royal soothsayer.
You know, I remember the autumn of 176.
Okay, who doesn't?
Suppose you should consider yourself lucky you're even here, considering historically speaking, you're not here.
Fair.
And I suppose we should also acknowledge the cool twist of fate, where I'm played by an Englishman, and you are played by a Frenchman.
Can we move on to less unsettling things? Please, let's speak of your wife.
How do you find that less unsettling?
Noted. Oh, here's good news. Her banishment to Capri went through. Straight through.
Excellent. And is she going to be executed?
I don't know. That's a lot of paperwork, too.
Just call me when the really horrific stuff happens.
Ha, that's usually what I say about you.
What was that? Did you hear that?
Oh, no, not a noise now. I would just like to get through one Senate meeting where you didn't hear a noise. I just want to get home and eat my cheesecake, dear Senate members.
Why would I leave? When I'm living rent-free, right up here.
Get off of me. Guards! You call those guards?
With all your plundering, you're lucky we aren't reduced to an old maid and a sick cat. You have a cat?
Ha! Dare you! How dare you! I never plundered anyone! Around here.
Oh, is that so? Forgive me. I suppose you didn't actually come in and take our furniture from us, but I did have to sell it off so that you wouldn't do just that.
Wait. You're a riot, Theo.
Shall we move on to the official name change?
That has headache written all over it. If you wish, scribe.
How could he possibly read something before I said it?
We all know you so well. Give me the document, please. All right. The Emperor proposes to change his name to
Caesar Marcus Aurelius Commodus Antonius Augustus, because that will fit on Welcome Back from War banners.
I don't plan to go to war.
Well, it won't fit on World's Best Emperor chalices either.
Oh, Emperor, I wish you wouldn't. I beg your pardon.
Caesar Marcus Aurelius Commodus Antonius Augustus, I wish you wouldn't.
Unlike you, someone named Mortimer thought they could be a better king than you? Look it up. I also happen to know that you're trying to undo what Richard II did, not your father.
Ah, does your father still enforce his clothes with steel rods in case he breaks?
Yes, and it's not working.
You know, there aren't as many grapes around here as I imagined.
We don't have grapes anymore.
Yeah, the way your whole empire kind of just rolled over on this one, I kind of got that too.
Cantaloupe?
What, is that your safe word during political discussions?
No, I am offering you a melon.
Oh, don't mind if I do.
What was I just thinking?
What? What's that?
I said, what was my friend H is thinking?
H is thinking? I don't know that person.
Who? The person who suggested we sit down and meet over this?
Foolery. Hey, what I came here for isn't foolery. You take that back.
Won't.
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 Is this how you conduct business? Little guy, hands on your hips?
That was one time.
Were you wearing those shoes at the time?
You're impossible.
Hey, I've been fair through this whole thing. You simply give me all your money, and I will kill you.
If you wanted to kill us, you could anyway. You were probably planning on taking us over, aren't you?
Yep, you got me. Take over this whole place.
Oh, and while I'm at it, I might as well go to the west.
All I have to do to get rid of that emperor is just deflate his little rubber ducky he plays with in the bath. Which brings me to my point. Where are the plans?
You have taken a lot from me, sir.
What, did you have to stop using Brill Cream on those locks of yours?
My rebuttal to that is as follows.
Ditto.
Taking these plans from me are positively the last things you will take from me, the absolute last.
Make a note of it.
Oh, right. You can't read!
Alright. Don't get your toga in a twist.
Robe.
Fine. Don't get your robe rumpled. Just get me the plans.
Fine. I have them over here.
Ah, well, now you're gonna have to change your password.
Thank you.
I know how hard this was for you.
Alright, everything seems to be in order.
Well, I'll be, so that's how you're doing, huh?
Huh.
Alright, I'll take this back to the Huns, and my kingdom thanks you very, very much. Say hello to the wife for me.
Oh. Sorry. I hope you're happy now. Now you know how to construct a bath. Couldn't be happier.
You're going to be no good king if you don't understand the importance of random conversation and idle threats.
Well, I suppose that is all for our meeting today. Unless His Majesty would like to devalue our currency again.
I think we're all finished.
So do I. So do I.
You know what I'm going to say. I don't have to tell you.
Oh, but would you please?
I think you should be nicer to people.
It wouldn't hurt.
That is where you are wrong.
But if you treated people kinder, they would be kinder to you.
How long have you lived in Gotham, Dad?
I don't live in Gotham.
Well, Gotham adjacent. Okay, the world does not work like that. Then if I am not mistaken, your parents weren't exactly a prime example of kindness.
Exactly.
What? What? What does that mean? You are not going to finish that sentence, are you? Oh God, this is just like when you walk halfway up the staircase and stand there silent before continuing up. Why do old folks do that? What are they thinking about? They'll never know.
Son, you read into things too much. Sometimes, pausing halfway up the stairs is just pausing halfway up the stairs. I'm going to get another dessert.
That is not good for your health.
So I'll scrape off the custard.
It's custard pie!
Hey, you guys always like this?
Well, we fight because we care.
I see. You guys must care a lot. You think your old man will show you more respect? You're being mayor of Gotham.
Well, he doesn't encourage me to be self-important or anything, but...
But what?
It's hard to explain. He just makes me feel like... I matter.
Now I'd like to share some Kitch at Home artifacts with you all. You all, y'all, whatever. After my tape recorder days, I recorded all my online shows on this, now broken, white MP3 player. Nowadays, I record on this handheld mini tape.
What is this museum tour we're getting? I got a ticket here for a show. What about a song?
We want a song!
We want a song!
We want a musical!
A song?
This isn't a musical, it's a presentation!
It's a... Alright... Gil Godwin, hit it!
Ladies and gentlemen, Hotel Hollywood proudly presents your hostess with the mostest, the very talented, Mrs. Kitch.
Whoa!
Kitch at home, now you won't have to be home alone. My mom said be an actor, my hon, but be a comical one started when I was 3. And the jokes, they were left up to me. Monologues and knock-knock jokes are there, I don't know. But people started laughing, whether friend or my foe. So one day in my attic, I created the show. Kitch at home, kitch at home, kitch at home. Radio was my dream, but my guests really steal all the scenes. Adam Lambert...
was our first call.
Then I invited them all. We write poems, we make stews, and we don't care who comments or views.
Sterling's Lost in Wonderland, the penguins escaped. Dustin needs direction chat with Norm and Bates. And have you seen the Rolling Stones are baking a cake?
Kitch at home, Kitch at home, Kitch at home. Bob can analyze you after uncomfortable interviews. Danny K is coming today.
Today the potato tongue twisted, that's hard to say.
Meat for food, come unglued. It's surprising we haven't been sued.
Mary, Fraser, Dick, Van Dyke, Show, Taxi, and MASH. Batman, Black Book, Star Wars, Star Trek, don't even ask. And then we got Rod Serling here to narrate the past.
Kitch at home, Kitch at home, Kitch at home. Kitch at home, Kitch at home. Now you won't have to be all alone.
Thank you all for listening and coming to play. You know we all learn something new about every day. Exactly, you pronounce it Timotationally.
What? Whose phone is that? We distinctly said this was a no-cell phone.
Oops.
Pee-wee.
I forgot. I was so busy and...
That's okay. You can't think of everything.
Do you want me to put it on airplane mode or...
Wait, I'll help him.
Maybe later. I want to turn it off, not
yeah,
just turn down.
Airplane mode.
It turns it off.
Here,
or...
let me see.
Well, my picture phone doesn't act
it's
up like this.
Here, turn it off.
Okay, there.
Are we good?
We're good.
All right.
Kitch at home. Kitch at home. Kitch at home. Make 'em laugh, make 'em laugh. Kitch at home.
I know I am, but what are you? I messed that up. No, I know the line. I made it.
Of course I know the line.
Look, you invited all of these swell celebrities here. You know, I don't have to tell you.
Oh, I do have to tell you?
What? Oh, from your past shows. Is that not gonna work? Okay, I'll go back.
Yeah, I sound like that other guy. What's his name?
Edward G. Robinson.
What?
No, go away, Edward. We don't need you right now.
Oh, that was certainly rude. Yeah, it certainly was. And this is why we don't have a scene with you two at the same time. Yeah, I will Spock listen to in the morning.
Sorry. I didn't make up that joke yet. Wait. Sorry.
Hey, don't I know you from someplace?
Nope.
Are you sure? I swear I've seen you before. There's some crummy piano playing in the background.
Uh-uh.
Were you the guy from Reno?
Was I? No.
I'm gonna get this. Where are you exactly?
In the desert.
Listen, Cassandra. I forgot who I was talking to there for a minute. Elvira, got it.
For what?
That would have been good, but my knee popped just then. It was so dramatic till my knee popped.
We must be present. Live in the moment.
Are you sure? Because I could live without this one.
A grudge.
Oh, I'm sorry. Darn you.
Try and stay in the scene, Jim.
He's minding the bookstore to make the bookstore. The bookstore. Making sure the customers come in. Making sure the customers don't come in.
Ah, English language is bullocks.
Comedy pub.
No.
Gigglescape.
Mm-mm.
Open humor.
Nope.
Uncle Chuckles.
No.
Bar humor.
No.
Laugh till you stop.
No.
Comedy cellar.
Where are these places?
Great, another thing I missed out on doing Hoop Scout films. I shout so I'm sure that I get the language. Great, another thing I missed out on doing Hoop Scout films. Hoop Scout! I must attack the English language for it to work. Are we all agreed? I'm not gonna argue with you.
I'll scrape off the custard. It's lemon pie! Lemon? What is it?
Chocolate.
Dad, it was custard.
Oh well, I almost got away with it. I know you from somewhere. Now help me out.
That laugh.
I can picture it now. You were holding a tape recorder. It was part of your act.
Well, we all start out with a tape recorder.
You know it. Until next time, this has been Kitch at Home. Bye!